Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum to all my viewers and students. Please don't forget to subscribe my channel. And also, if you have issues in regarding your data analysis part in your thesis or research paper, you may contact me on my email address or on my WhatsApp number given here. You may be from any field, you may contact for your data analysis. Today I am going to elaborate that how can we perform confirmatory fact analysis in SmartPLS version 4, and this is a basic part in which we discuss that either our items are related to our variables or not, and we confirm that all the factors are representing well. So prior to start our confirmatory analysis, I have told you in my last video that this is my basic model, and I want to build all made my all videos on the basis of this model, because every student have his or her own research model, and that might be a simplest one from this one or more complex from this one. But when you have a specific model, you have to follow the steps according to validate and find out the your hypothesis acceptance or rejection of your model. Then you have to perform analysis in step to step wise. So I plan to make videos regarding considering that point, that I have to choose a model, and on the basis of that I will show you how we can perform its basic analysis, like confirmatory factor analysis, how we will find out the its convergent validity, its discriminant validity, and then further we will go to test our hypothesis. In this model, almost I have made 22 hypotheses in according to this model, and I will show you in step by step analysis that how we will validate these hypotheses in upcoming videos. So this is my basic model, and it has basically three mediators, two dependent variables, one for moderation effect, and one independent variable. In other models you may have different variable setting, might be students may have more than one or two independent variables, one or two mediators, and similarly they may have a different dependent variables. In this model you can also see that there is a parallel and sequential mediation. That's why I incorporated this model here, that it will provide you an opportunity to learn that how we can run a sequential or parallel mediation with moderation, and I will show you how we will run a simple moderation effect and mediation effect. I also apologize for that my most of the videos will be a little bit lengthy, but my aim is to that I should explain each and everything that is involved in data analysis process, and especially for when we are running in the software, I want to explain everything in detail that a student will learn in detail, and he or she should understand all the process that software have. Regarding data in and result interpretation, a student can easily get impact factor journals, thesis online available in the Google Scholars, or they may be following certain papers, and they also have well explained our interpretation process, so student can follow those papers are thesis when they are setting or writing up their results. But the basic motive in this in these videos are to explain you, to teach you the exact process that when you follow this and get your desired results. In my previous videos, I showed that how can we import the data set in the SmartPLS 4 and how we can construct our base model. I have to save my time, I have constructed a base model that I have shown you in my slide that I am working on it. So here is my base model. On the basis of the study, although in my study there are more number of items in my model. For example, dependent variable has more than 7 items, dependent variable B also have more than 7, but for the simplicity and for the good view, I have made taken a less number of items to show exact the calculation working and the models in a proper and effective way. So here is the my data set. At the last of videos, when I complete my this all complete model like mediation, moderation, regression, multiple regression, all when I complete my all series video, I will share the data set with you students in online that they can easily work on it and perform the analysis for their learning purpose. So I am not going to further detail on it. This is my basically data sets information that variables and their respective items here are shown. Mediation, moderation, like for example I told you that my dependent variable have 16 items, but due to display issue I have just taken the 7 items, although in my main study I have considered all these full items data. I little just take your time for a moment that how we can manage these items or can align them, can make a good visible. There are certain things I want to show you. In my previous videos I try to show you, but I again here to tell you that how, although most of the time we are easy to construct a model in our SmartPLS 4 and 3 also. Here you can align the item. For example, you select all the items here and you can by selecting you can move up or down here to align the items accordingly. It could be also be realigned. For example, if you find the spaces are more between the items and the items are expanding beyond the limits, then you can close the distance between them by moving the items accordingly, and they have no, you see that the green lines help you out to align the items in a sequence. So this will help you out to reduce the your space in the SmartPLS environment, and you can construct a better research model. So these are the things that you can, when you practice you will learn it. This is my model. Now you can see this is my single independent variable with the 4 items. There are 3 mediators, mediator A, mediator B and mediator C, and here is a dependent variable A and B, 2 dependent variable and 1 for moderator. When we run moderation, we show the moderating effect on IV and between the mediator 1A, but just I am here to first perform confirmatory effect analysis, so I have to just link the moderation with the my respective dependent variable. For example, if the moderation is between the IV and DV, I have to show you basically the moderation should represent here, but when I have to run confirmatory factor analysis, I should consider it as a IV for this mediator, and I have to link this because when we add moderation it will affect certain confirmatory factor analysis, for example correlation and other things. Due to lack of time I cannot show you the whole working of this. Just here this is my in this model, then we are going to run a confirmatory factor analysis easily. When you have your own research model, first you have to develop like this. You have to portray or draw the full model here to perform the confirmatory analysis because in SmartPLS, confirmatory factor analysis is run on the your whole model. So you have to construct your full model in first step to validate or to confirm the items or the factors that you have taken in your studies. Once this confirmatory factor analysis will be performed, then you can break up your this model accordingly, because many of items here can be deleted due to I will show you that they may be affecting your confirmatory analysis results. So once you finalize your model here by running your confirmatory factor analysis, then you go with the different regressions or different hypothesis testing on the basis of this model. I will show you in next videos. Okay, here I have taken the full model and I directly go to run the this model. Another thing you have to look on it, and it is very important, when you run this model, as your this model is a confirmatory, it is a reflective model. Here you will see that it is a reflective model. Reflective model is that arrows heads are pointing outside to the your variable or this blue circle. Therefore, this is these are called reflective measures. For formative, their direction is inward, and they are considered as a formative scale. These about reflective formative I will discuss in detail in upcoming videos, where I will show you how can we differentiate between formative and reflective measures. Here you can see that there is a when we run on comes to the calculation, there is a first option PLS SEM algorithm, then bootstrapping, then other options are available which will we discuss in later videos. But here is two main differences that I want to show you, that when you have a reflective measures, your all items your all model is a reflective model, then you have to use PLS SEM consistent PLS SEM algorithm, and for path coefficient you will run consistent PLS SEM bootstrapping. But if you have any a single, might be you may have a single formative variable formative construct, then you have to use PLS SEM algorithm. So simply, if we have a formative construct, then we will use PLS SEM algorithm, simple one. And if we have all our reflective measures, then we will use the reflective measures, we will use consistent PLS SEM algorithm. So for the confirmatory and factor analysis, I am going to run the PLS consistent PLS SEM algorithm. I am not going to run bootstrapping. Bootstrapping is used to find out the coefficient significance, which will be discussed in hypothesis testing in the upcoming videos. Now I click on the consistent PLS SEM algorithm. Consistent, when we use it, is consistent. It will its menu will be open here, and you have information regarding your analysis. The first one, if you click on the PLS setup, there are two options. Either you can use factor analysis or path analysis. And when we perform confirmatory factor analysis, we will select factor analysis. And here in the types of result, there are basically three types of result you can use. There are a standardized, unstandardized, and mean centered. Mostly in most of the studies we follow the standardized result, so here we will select standardized. either you can use unstandardized or mean centric. Mean centric mean they will take the average of the value, and on the basis that they standardize the data. Here initial weights could be on the default or for on the basis of individual. We will select default here also. It should remain on the default setting. Here in the below to the start calculation, you will see that there is a open report. If we select on the open report, then when the analysis will be performed, the report automatically will be open and you can easily view the results. If either you do not select this open report, the result will be shown there and you have to open manually or on next step. So I selected it open report, it will automatically generate the results and we can easily see the results there. I now click on the adjust selected factors. There is no need to change in the data setting, it should remain the same. In the PLS setup, just select the factors because we are doing confirmatory factor analysis, and just I will click on the start calculations option. It will show the progress. It takes very less time to calculate the confirmatory factor analysis, but it takes time when we run on the bootstrapping for our data analysis purpose. Now here is the output when we run the confirmatory or any analysis. You will see, you can here see the results. You can take the cursor on right side to expand the output or the output options that are available on your left hand side. Here you can see the analysis output is here. Basically, if I show you that the whole model is run in this, and all the path coefficient, their factor loadings and everything is shown here, but at the time when we are performing CFA, we are just concerned about the factor loadings and other measurement that are necessary for our confirmatory factor analysis. Because for path coefficients, we will focus on the confirmatory factor analysis. Many of the item might be creating issue for our factor loadings, or for issue creating for convergent validity or for our discriminant validity. So here you will see that on the left side of the information, you can choose can see the results there. The first one is the basically, if I click on to quickly I show you that what type of outputs are shown here. That is for the first one is the path coefficient. Path coefficient are the basically the coefficients of like IV to DV, mediator and mediator to DV. These are called as a path coefficient and shown here, and you can view in the report also. Here the matrix, it is shown in the matrix here, in the matrix form, and we are not going to discuss here it, because we will discuss in the when we will test a hypothesis, or when we will be confirm that our model or the item are representing their constructs or not. And similarly, these are the it was in matrix form. Now these are in the list form, directly showing the IV on DVA, the path coefficient is 0.206 and so on. And you can also view as a graphical, the green icons are showing positive effect and red are showing negative effect. Similarly, when we have a mediation or moderation, we have also indirect effects, and that are necessary for to confirm our mediation or moderation effect, and they are not discussed here now. Similarly, we will have a total effect, and what is the indirect effect, total effect, it will be shown when we run mediation or moderation analysis. The more concern about in confirmatory factor analysis with our in the first time, that is our outer loading. you can see here the there are two options available for showing your outer loading. That is the first we click on the matrix. Here you will see that the this create and matrix. A matrix basically showing the loadings of the self variable on variable on self or with the other construct. The red options are there are two basically you can see the outcome. One is for green and one is for red. The green are the factor loading that are greater than 0.07 as we have a basic criteria for factor loadings in our previous studies that it must be greater than 0.70 most criteria. If the values are higher than 0.708 then you will have no issue on your composite reliability and Cronbach alpha or average variance extracted especially. But in some cases when all the things are good, sometimes we accept the loadings less than 0.708. It depends on the results we get from the composite reliability and the average variance extracted. So here the results are in a matrix form. If I show you that here you can see that these seven items are representing these seven items are representing that for example dependent A variable, my first dependent variable, and it has a seven items. But you will notice here that the all items have a green values, mean they have a value greater than 0.07, but one item here is DVA 6 has the value less than 0.07, so it is marked as a red. So when we perform a confirmatory effect analysis, its loading is very low to the as compared to the 0.70, so it should not be or we can drop this item in our variable. This will improve our composite reliability. This will also improve our average variance extracted. I will show you in next step. This was the basically matrix view of the outer loadings of all items for their respective variables, and their cross loading also show that the DVA is not cross have no cross loading with other variable, so its items are not correlated. This shows that its items are not correlated with other variable item, and this is a good for a model fitness. And if an item is cross loaded with others or have a cross correlations, then there can be an issue of the in composite reliability or model fitness for a specific variable. This can also view as a list, and I preferably look at as a list, not as a matrix, because you may be confused that which items are loading have a loading greater than 0.70 and have a cross loading or not. This help a lot about, but you can easily view here in the list and can find that there is a DVA1. DVA has a loading 0.860 green. I can show that it has loading greater than 0.70 and it should not be dropped. But here you can also see that the DVA6 has the factor loading which is 0.070, very less than 0.070, so we can drop it from our loading, and this will improve our average variance extracted or composite reliability. And if we are facing an issue in that, then we can we will see that after dropping it will improve the model fitness also. So the all red marked items are showing that these items must be dropped excluded from the model. Here you can see that the some items are creating problem or have the loadings less than 0.070, so I have to drop these items. In case if my model fitness are not good or I am facing the issue in my composite reliability and average variance extracted next step. Here after this is the outer loadings and here the outer weights. I will quickly show you that matrix in a matrix form. These are the load outer weights. You can also focus on the outer weights and compare the outer weights with other like we have said earlier. We see in the outer loading mode list wise DVA6 has the red value, mean its value is less than 0. The SmartPLS will highlight all those values which have loading value less than 0.70. So it highlighted this DVA6, and when we go to the outer weights, this basically it will creates the weight according to their items, and you can also see here that the DVA6 has a weight lower than all other items of the DVA. So it also recommend us that we should drop it to improve our model fitness. This goes always viewed as a matrix and a list. Next thing comes to the latent variables. When we click on the latent variables, you have two options here. The first one is the correlations and second one is the covariance. Basically this is the correlation table. You can report, mostly we have to report this correlation table in our results section after after our confirmatory factor analysis. So you can simply copy this information and paste into the Excel and just realign the values by removing these upper values or lower values, and this will create your correlation table. And the correlation analysis is basically showing that the how DVA is related to with the DVB, that is a negative relationship between two dependent variable. For example, IV has a DVA correlation with DV as a positive 0.517. so here the correlation values are shown here. You can just copy it and paste there and interpret the results. So positive correlation have both movement in the same direction, either in the positive direction, either in the both in a negative direction. But for negative correlation, you know that the they have opposite movement. One has positive, one is increasing and other is decreasing, and so on. We are not going to discuss here in detail, but you can find the correlation in analysis between the variables here, and you can just copy it. You can now they have allow you that you can select this information and just copy it in and paste in your first in Excel file, make certain formatting, and then you can report in the Word file. Covariance relationship also is shown here. Correlations values are and covariances are represented both in there. Here is the residuals, and we are not concerned with the residuals here. These residues are not reported here, but in some time we can see the residual when we have a model fitness issue. The basic confirmatory factor analysis is confirmed by these quality criteria. The quality criteria is the basically shows the significance of your model. Basically here is the first is the R-square, but R-square is the for the path coefficients or path analysis, so it is not considered as the measure for the confirmatory factor analysis. Similarly, F-square is also for the to see the effect of one variable on other, and its effect we have to see that either its effect is significant or not significant. I will tell you in detail when I will perform regression analysis or path analysis. To validate our model, for our confirmatory factor analysis, you have more concern about the construct reliability and validity issue. So here when you click on the construct reliability, you will have the information regarding the basic four criteria to measure the construct reliability. The first one is the Cronbach alpha, as previously seen SmartPLS 3 was given, also shown here row A criteria, composite reliability and average variance extracted. As we know that the threshold criteria for the for these measures are the Cronbach alpha is considered to good if it has a value greater than 0.70. Similarly, row A should also be greater than 0.70. Composite reliability is preferably 0.070 to 0.095. It should be between to the 0.70 to 0.95, and the average variance extracted must be greater than the 0.50. Here in this model, I can see that the DVB has the issue in average variance extracted. Its average variance extracted value is a 0.457, which is less than the 0.50. So here we can see that there could be issue in our construct, because its average variance extracted is very low. But some author says that when you have a Cronbach alpha higher than 0.70 or composite reliability is higher than 0.70, then you can go with these type of value, average variance extracted, if it is less than 0.50. but if you are facing issue in your composite reliability or in the Cronbach alpha or in other measures, then you have to look into the items and maybe by dropping one or two items that have a very low loading, by removing that, your composite reliability or average variance extracted can be increased. Like I've shown that we have seen that in my DVA there was an item that has the value lower than 0.70, but other items have a loading more than 0.70. Here therefore you can see that the Cronbach alpha for this is 0.873 and composite reliability is a 0.903, and average variance extracted is also 0.601. Basically this is due to that when you have more items, or 5-7 or more items, sometimes they have a higher factor loading, and a single item which may have a very low loading can be compensated by the other factor. So your reliability issue does not remain there. You can go with that model easily and you can run the model, but if you again think that its loading is still very low and can be checked or can be recommended to delete it, then you can remove that item. It will also improve your model fitness, but there are both options available here. Either you go with the same setting or remove the item which have factor loading lower than the given criteria. You can use the both options because overall there is a no issue of your composite reliability or Cronbach alpha or average variance extracted. So I will show you by removing that what the result could we get, either it improves or not. In construct reliability and validity, there are different options available in the SmartPLS 4. First, you have seen the overview in a tabulated form, and you have to report these information similarly like I show you in correlation analysis. Then you have to select this table and copy it and paste in your Excel file, and then Excel by certain formatting you will incorporate in your Word file. There's the overview. This is the overview of your composer reliability information or reliability construct, reliability and validity issue. Then you can see the separately the graphs of the each one, like Cronbach alpha, row A for example, composite reliability and average variance extractor. Graphically you can also view well about your construct. Here for example, DVB is red marked, it means there is an issue in the average variance extractor for the DVBA. The second step is comes to the this shows the convergent validity of your construct or construct reliability and validity. The next thing comes is the discriminant validity. Discriminant validity is measured in basically in two ways. The first one we preferably use or in a used in the previous studies are the Forner-Larker criteria. What is the Forner-Larker criteria? The Forner-Larker criteria is the basically the correlation analysis. It is a correlation analysis among the variable that I have shown you in previously, that what are the correlation values between the all variables, all the construct variables. But here you have the values on diagonal in the correlation table. We see here the value 1111, but in the Forner-Larker criteria you have a certain diagonal values, and these diagonal values are the basically the the diagonal values are the basically the square root of AVE. We will call it is the square root of average variance extracted. If you take the square root of the average variance extracted, previously I have shown you in construct reliability and validity part, you have seen that the average variance extracted values. So basically these values are the square root of the average variance extracted. Now what is the criteria? That the all diagonal values should be higher than the its lower values. Diagonal values should be basically square root of AVE must be higher than the correlations of the constructs. I can write here that the diagonal values must be greater than correlations of each construct, each variable karne aap variables, correlations of each variables. So if the diagonal values are the higher than the correlations value, then you have no issue in your discriminant validity. There is no problem of discriminant validity. We can see here that the all values of the construct correlation values are of the constructs are lower than the diagonal values, mean square root of the average variance extracted. This is called Forner-Larker criteria, which was used in our previous studies to validate the discriminant validity of the construct. Now they have just introduced a new measure to the measurement to validate discriminant validity for the discriminant validity, that is the heterotate monotate ratio. The heterotate monotate ratio is shown here. The criteria for this is that it should be preferably it should be less than 0.80, and if it is a less than it could be less than 0.85, but preferably it is recommended by many of authors that its value should be less than 0.80. and if the all values are less than 0.80, it's mean you have no issue in your discriminant validity of the construct here. Like you can see the all values are less than 0.80, and but here you can see that the moderation effect moderator with DVB has the value of 0.77 0.66 and here is 0.726, which is higher than all other variables, but as it is less than 0.80, and we can go with this model and we can perform the further analysis, for example path analysis or our hypothesis testing. And this is for discriminant validity. Two methods are used, the heterotrade monotrade ratio that I have shown you, and that was shown in the numerical value. Here you can see the its graphical view. All the values are higher, less than 0.80, so they are all green marked. If the values you have more than 0.80, it will be red marked. Similarly, we have a Forner Larker criteria. I will explain it. You can also notice the cross loadings of the items. Cross loading of items, the items have loadings, the items of same contracts have a loadings higher or than the other cross loading. For example, DV items have a these are loadings with own construct has a higher value, like they have more than value 0.80, but its values are less than less with other construct. This also confirms that all items of DVA are representing the DVA mean. DVA 7 items are representing the DVA variable. The items are not correlated with the other items, are not representing with the other. This also confirmed. Next thing, here you can see the variance inflation factor VIF that allows you to see that there is no issue of multicollinearity. The VIF of each variable construct is given here, and you can see all the values are green except the first three one, the DVA1, DVA2, DVA3. The preferably range, the most, if we restrict it, it should be less than less than 3. But it is in more of the study we use the value less than 5 is also used, and in some cases we also accept the VIF values less than 10, but higher than 5 or higher than 10 as certain alarming, and we should neglect these, or we have to if there is a presence in the among the variables, you can delete them or remove them. But if mostly VIF is considered for the constructs like see in the our correlation analysis, if the item, if the variables have a strong correlation and higher correlation, that can issue, that can create the issue of multicollinearity. There we can remove the those items or deal with different ways there. But in construct VIF values, if are less than 5, you can go with this and perform your analysis similarly. The next thing comes here, the outer models. This VIF for the outer models mean representing the items VIF, the items of a variable. And for inner model, these are the values regarding the showing the variance inflation factor among the variables. All variables are, you can see, have the green value, means their values are less than 3 or less than 5, so there is a no issue for the multicollinearity here. It also confirms that there is a no issue of multicollinearity in our model. The next thing comes is the model fit. Model fit is the certain measures are given here, that SR, MR, D upper limit, D, G chi square values, and NFI. If you have simple, you have two criteria. This is a saturated model and this is an estimated model. This is the complete shows the complete model values. This is the what we have estimated model results here. You can simply follow the criteria here, that the SRMR value should be less than 0.80. 0.08, sorry, its value is best fitted if we have a value 0.08, and for the NFI it must be near to equals to or greater than 0.90. but overall our model is showing a fitness that there is no issue, just due to certain item that we I have shown you that have created an issue in average variance extracted are that were red marked. Therefore you can see here the little bit variation or lower values in your model fitness. By removing that item, it will definitely improve your model, and this model fit will also improve. Other information in here is about the model selection criteria, and this is the information they have applied, the Bayesian information criteria. They take the minimum value for model fitness, and you can simply show or can report your Bayesian information criteria that overall model was run and these minimum values were achieved. The other part shown below here is not used in our data analysis purpose, but this is the extra information. You can go with this and to further check out your information that they have provided in a SmartPLS 4. For example, this is the about the setting of the algorithm, that how they run, they have their own calculations. You need not to report in anywhere in your data analysis part, so you are not concerned. Indicator original data is basically your own data that you have in your data set. It will be it can be shown in the matrix form or in each variables in a descriptive form, and similarly these are the data you have entered in your data set, and these are the descriptive results. Your indicators data can also be viewed as a standardized data, and you can here see the indicators data in standardized form. Further, for each indicator, correlation with other can also be seen here. You can easily can see here, but again I will show you that I told you that you are not concerned about these criteria. You are mostly concerned about the quality criteria in your confirmatory factor analysis, and especially for auto loadings. So here I come back again to my auto loading, and the red marked variables which are here is the red mark. I will definitely drop these variables to improve my model fitness, and I will see that how my model fit will improve and the average variance extracted issue can either it can be resolved or not. So here I will go back to the main model, and I have noted the values that have lower factor loading, and I will delete this and check either model improves or not. For example, DVA 6, I can zoom in it here. I can zoom it and see the DVA 6. You can see here that it has a value 0.70, so I have to remove this value. By removing this, you can see that the all factor loadings are gone, and you have to rerun the model. Therefore, you first note the variables that have a lower factor loading, and then you can easily delete them and again rerun, instead of by running again and again and removing one by one variable. Similarly, in DVB4, I have DVB4 and 6. These two have the very low value, so I remove these values in next. I have issue in a mediator C, and in mediator C there is a basically is my third mediator, and here the item C2 is creating problem. It has lower value. Similarly, for moderation moderator variable, there are two items that have very lower factor loading, like 3 and 4. So as we have more number of items, our number of items are greater than 3 or 5, so we can remove the items. By removing these items, it will not create any issue. There is no restriction in removing the items, we can go through it and remove the item. Now, minimum item should be less than 4 of measuring a certain variable. Might be if 3 2 but not less than 2 for in scale. I will run it again and show you either its model fitness improved or not. I just rerun this one and selected the path analysis and start calculation, and the result will appear here. Again, I just go auto loadings, and in auto loadings we will say list. Now you can see one variable is again, it has a load factor loading. We can also remove it, but you can now understand that how can we remove the variables. Go to the construct validity. Now you can see the average variance extracted of each variables have improved, and the one we have, once we have DV load, average variance extracted has now improved by removing the items that have a load loadings. Similarly, for model fitness discriminant validity, we have shown there was no issue already, and model fitness is also improved. The 891 and our saturated model has the values. SRM errors value is less than 0.08, and the NFI also improved to 0.907, and we have to consider this the saturated model values for our model fitness. So this is about all about the confirmatory factor analysis, and in upcoming videos I will show how we break this model in stepwise to test our hypothesis, because this is in the first for the performance of the confirmatory factor analysis in SmartPLS. First you have to draw the full model and test the confirmatory factor analysis, then after that you can test your hypothesis. You can break the model into different parts, like IV to DV effect, IV to mediator, mediator to DV, and DV to that we report in the hypothesis. For research paper, you can go with this model simply and find out the results and report and interpret, because the in research paper we have a limitation of the words, and we can just go with the simple model and simple whole model and the whole analysis. Thank you very much. Very sorry for a lengthy video, but my aim is, again I repeat here, that to explain each and everything to the students or viewers, that he or she can understand it well. Thank you very much.